First, to me, an event of 1992, where the prosecution was launched in 1994, to be tried in 2017. It's a telling commentary on the criminal jurisprudence of this country. Instead of being just laudatory, we must also be circumspect of what is happening to the entire system. If criminal jurisprudence is to take 25 years to just decide whether there is a necessity of looking at the evidence or not, I think we need to be more circumspect on this. Secondly, whether it's a question of morality or not, which I just heard Mr. Kapil Sibal, I will address in the later part. Let me hear the others and then I have a few things to say. I am just reminded one more thing of what was observed in the Libran Commission report. Because there was a commission which was immediately constituted by Mr. Narasimha Rao, which was given 48 extensions. And after nearly 16 years or 17 years, in 2010, it gave its report, which I will refer to later. Here was a classical case of political vendetta and political witch hunting to say there was a conspiracy. But one more thing, I am happy that, chalo, Supreme Court has decided, let's once and for all, we'll put an end to this chapter. This nation needs to now be governed on the issue of good governance and development.
Okay.
You know, this will just give chance to these pseudo-secularists to beat their chest and do a lot of chest thumping.
Okay.
You know, I'm sad that the process of developmental politics will take up this thing.
Okay, just quickly, Mr. Mittal, I just have to interrupt you there, Mr. Mittal, just to say, you know, just to quote the court really, which said that in the present case, crimes which shake the secular fabric of the Constitution of India have allegedly been committed almost 25 years ago, and the accused persons have not been brought to book largely because of the conduct of the CBI in not pursuing the prosecution of the alleged offenders in a joint trial, and because of technical defects which were easily curable, but which were not cured by the state government. So, you know, your point is that why so late? That, of course, is just the tragedy of the Indian judicial system. We can, of course, look at all of that, but a significant beginning has been made, says Dushyant Dave. Abhishek Singhvi, you want to come in at this point quickly, sir? Yes. That, you know, they might be in the twilight of their lives, of their political careers, but someone's got to take moral and political responsibility for what happened, for perhaps creating a movement, creating something which just got out of control. It really is a new chapter, a turning point for India's political history. We've never been the same again, and many would even argue that we're still facing the consequences.
Natasha ji, what are we discussing today first? Let us confine ourselves to the discussion. We are discussing that the Supreme Court has today ruled that the evidence for the conspiracy theory must be examined to determine whether these people are guilty or not. That's all. That's about it. Now, I have heard Mr. Singhvi talking about the central government being that of BJP in 2001 and the CBI not responding or not filing an appeal to that. Mr. Singhvi, you from 2004 to 2014 were the bosses of the CBI. You should have done it. Who prevented you? You had the Libran Commission giving the report to you on your dictates in 2010. You should have gone further and did something about it. So foreign order which took place in 2001. Today, 2017, it has taken 16 years for somebody to decide that, order of the High Court needs a review. Please keep quiet. I don't intervene in between. Mr. Singhvi, I expect you to be a decent man. I think we can have a decent debate. We don't need to make it a fish market.
Okay, Mr. Singhvi, carry on, make your point.
Wait for your turn to speak to them. So here, I am hearing the strangest thing about political morality. Now, where is the issue of political morality on a cooked up charge, a political charge by the Congress regime in 1994.
But Mr. Mittal, let me ask you, won't the courts decide that? Even if you say it's a cooked up charge, the Supreme Court has found enough merit in saying, yes, let them be tried for conspiracy. It's the Supreme Court of India.
So I have, have you protested against that? We said, well, it has taken them 16 years
to decide. But isn't it an indictment, sir? Isn't it an indictment in many ways?
I am happy. No, sorry.
To know this.
Sorry, please. Please understand criminal jurisprudence of this country. In this country, filing of charges against somebody does not make that person guilty. He is guilty only when found to be guilty, otherwise he is innocent. The onus of guilt is on the state.
Okay.
The person
okay.
is deemed to be innocent till the time he's been proven
okay,
to be guilty.
Okay, you made your point. Dr. Yes,
let's not misinterpret
law. Okay. And let's not do it for other conventions.
I always felt and I always thought that Mr. Mittal gets his papers organized and reads a lot before coming. It's obvious he hasn't read the judgment, or worse, having read it, he's deliberately ignoring it. When he talks of other people should have appealed in the 10 years past, he forgets graphic paragraphs in the judgment which point out how, when the state government refused permission in 2001, the CBI slept over it, allowed subsequent judgments to come,
okay.
and those subsequent judgments are the ones in appeal today. And the Supreme Court says that original judgment of 2001 February holds the field and the subsequent judgments are wrong. Now, there is no way in which Mr. Mittal's legal acrobatics can make a 2004 government okay. appeal against an order which was rejected in 2001.
I don't
when
think
other matters have superseded it. So, okay. this is completely contrary to the facts. And read the facts in the judgment that graphically.
So, can I?
That's
okay.
why the delay
yes,
argument is important.
Was, okay.
Who delayed it?
Mr.
Who delayed
okay.
it?
Okay, I was in fact going to come across to you, Sabha. I was going to ask you,
I've
heard what both sides say, Sabha. My question to you was going to be, is it quite clear now that the BJP is going to use this as a rallying point in 2019? It's interesting that the verdict's going to, the 2 years are going to be up just when the country's going to...
I mean, as I said, this judgment will only give a boost to these pseudo-secularists and the rank communalists who have been indulging in minority appeasement for vote bank politics. Because
let's
for the
try
next
another argument,
years,
sir.
Be,
Mr. Mittal, let's try some other argument.
Let me give you the argument. You haven't heard my full argument. Let me give you. Because as I said, we are least interested in diverting the developmental agenda of this government.
Okay.
The agenda of good governance. And
so
my
in that good
is
governance,
that,
isn't
as
in
you
that,
said,
does that
be,
good governance
as,
involve asking Uma Bharti to step down or not?
No, not at all. For the simple reason, let me tell you one thing. Let there be an indictment of Uma Bharti in terms of the evidence available. Surely
okay.
she'll step down.
Okay.
But till such time, she has not been indicted on a mere allegation by a hostile government of the Congress in 1994. It is most unfair to even talk about it because we should not have double standards.
Okay.
There
okay.
is a case of a family who has been charged with 420 IPC, which means fraud. They were being sent to jail when they sought bail and
okay,
they were
okay.
to bail.
Okay.
Nobody has asked them to step down.
Okay.
No, let's not.
Dr.
And when
Singh, yes.
Mr. Kapil Sibal talks about morality, it is laughable.
Okay. Dr. Singhvi, this whataboutry clearly
you know,
will carry
I think
on.
We need to listen. I've been shut off for about 3 minutes by your audio. I think you need to lighten the atmosphere. So let me ask a deliciously ironical question, which doesn't really require an answer. And that is, can you hear me?
Go
can
ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear.
Yeah, and that let us try and connect two unconnectable dots, seemingly unconnectable dots. The CBI suddenly redeems itself, as recorded in various paras of the judgment, by strongly arguing that the conspiracy charge should be revived. And
okay.
the presidential elections are a few months later.
This
that
is
not
okay. known as conspiracy theory.
But
Congress has Congress
but
is profoundly
okay. You might ask that
theory.
Question of yourself,
Mr. Singhvi. The Hindu terrorism was a conspiracy
okay.
theory.
So
demolition
no,
is a conspiracy
Rakesh,
theory.
We
no,
just
look,
have to.
Look,
no, no.
How
you make the point,
how
and others who have said
how
that even the end of the road for any presidential dream.
He's not casting doubt
okay.
on the CBI. He's
okay.
also casting doubt on the
okay.
Supreme Court.
Okay.
If Supreme Court is giving verdict,
Mr. Singhvi, you are conceding.
Okay, Sabha, I have to just
Mr.
give you the last word.
Mr. Singhvi,
I know. I know what I know.
I know. I thought you were a lawyer who believed in the Supreme Court.
I know what
we're just trying to hear from Sabha.
Okay. I know what you know, Natasha. I know what Mr. Singhvi is suggesting. It's been going round and round. But you know, frankly, Mr. Advani and Joshi and all, they're not, I mean, nobody needed to do something so complicated to get them out of a presidential race.
Right.
So I'm still not buying it, Mr.
That
Singhvi.
This is scripted
it's a
by
lovely
the
conspiracy
okay.
theory.
Okay.
But I'm
okay.
not convinced, you
okay.
know.
you're not convinced. But we just have to leave it at that. But thank you all so much for your time. Is the Ram Mandir back on the agenda? Back on the agenda? Is it back, of course, is center stage again in India? That's the big question. That's what we've tried to cover. This is clearly not the last word that has been spoken. In fact, Murali Manohar Joshi meeting with L.K. Advani at his residence on the day when Amit Shah made Uma Bharti call off that proposed trip to Ayodhya. Like I said, there's more on this to play out. We'll be tracking this story very, very closely.